Rush Talk is brought to you
Metropolitan International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro, and Marara. Contact or WhatsApp us on 0772-561-957. Email us at metropolitaniu@gmail.com. Empowerment through knowledge creation.
Thank you very much. Most definitely, Empowerment through knowledge creation. That is Kampala Metropolitan International. We partner with them every morning here between 9 and 10. And of course, we thank you, whatever you're watching. Thank you so much. And welcome aboard. My name is Miles Ramiti Apuli. And of course, we still encourage you to download the new Vision Digital app onto your telephone to be able to catch up to you, of course, catch up with all our programs here. At the same time, you can, of course, call us on our Twitter handle, which is RNTV Uganda, as well as Facebook, if you can. However, we appreciate your comments as well. You can appreciate your comments if you can, you know, send them through. We're going to be able to get a couple of things. You see the decoration. No. And please, red does not mean to move. Please, whatever car you're driving, please be extremely careful. Well, with me in the studio today, I am joined by my brother Anderson Broda from Rubaga, there as of course the RCC Rubaga, to talk about a few things. The man, you've seen him, of course, if you follow him, especially on his social media, he's very toxic. When you see the, you know, his comments and what he posts on social media there lately, he's here to tell us what is happening. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Miles.
Good to see you.
Good, happy to be here.
Yes, yeah.
And good morning to the listeners, viewers. I'm used to radio.
Really?
But also people, mothers.
Yes.
Mothers listen to TV.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So
you listen and watch.
No, they don't have time to watch.
Oh, they be listening.
Because they are entangled in a number of things. So they listen. Then if something catches, they should come and peep. She'll go back.
Okay, yeah, yeah, true. Okay.
Yes, sir.
How have you been? How is Rubaga Mania?
Yeah, in Rubaga we are doing well. Yesterday, the registration of the National Resistance Movement Party, the update and registration of the register began. I think it's the main activity we are now running after.
It began yesterday?
Yeah, it began yesterday and it ends on 17th. I think that will be a Sunday.
So
we encourage those who are participating to follow the guidelines, to do it in a manner that is respectful and not involving too malpractices. Like some have been doing, we arrested some yesterday. Yeah, they do. They call it, is it staffing? Someone comes. Puts in members who are not of that party with the idea that these people who have been put in at the time of election, they back a weak candidate. Yeah, they back a weak candidate who eventually gets the flag but cannot win the main election. That is the trick. Yeah, but we urge you to don't invite the attention of security. We don't want to seem as if we are manning, you know, we are being political in this sense. Sometimes they invite us and at the end of the day then they ask us, what have you come to do? But it is a mandate of the authorities to keep law and order.
Okay. So that's what's happening in Rwanda right now.
Yeah. It's countrywide. It's not in Rubaga alone. Okay. It's countrywide.
I am told you're a tough man. Are you
I
tough?
I don't think so. I am a very humble person.
Sabora is a tough man.
I'm a very humble person.
Looks at things, he doesn't joke around.
It depends. That's also a mindset.
Mm.
It depends on how you want to see things. It depends on the normal.
Mm.
See, once the abnormal supersedes or takes over the attention of the majority, the abnormal becomes the normal, and the normal becomes the abnormal.
Mm.
And that is the irony we are facing, that someone openly justifies what is wrong. I am not privileged. I don't want to say I'm privileged. I am not privileged that I work in a society that is full of needs. And then in the neighborhood, there is another entity that is supposed to facilitate these needs, and it is being wasteful. It is being inconsiderate based on the circumstances in this country. You are someone who is responsible for the welfare of this country. You know how our burden debt is. You know how informal our economy is, because that's where largely we get the money from.
Mm.
You know how we have been having issues with the development partners and how aid is being cut. You know how hard the people are recovering from COVID. And at the same time, you are not remorseful about it. You are not remorseful about how we are sending URA is prosecuting people every day for tax non-compliance. You know that?
Yes, sir.
So someone is in Ruzira, is sent in Ruzira for non-tax compliance, and is watching on TV that someone is spending lavishly as if they won lottery.
Mm.
Some things just don't make sense.
At all.
Mm.
Yes.
Yeah, I think.
Okay. For the last 2 weeks, social media has been awash with documents showing the money, that money is being misappropriated in Parliament. Where does this leave Parliament and our MPs?
I think now we don't qualify to call it a parliament.
Really?
I rarely now call anyone honorable. That's my individual call.
Okay.
I rarely call anyone in parliament honorable. Because honorable is a sacred title.
Yes, it is.
Imparted on you to stop you, to deter you from doing certain things that are not honorable. So if you participate in activities that make one recall or question whether you are one or not, in the first instance, why would we, you see, what puzzles me is that we have an auditor general, we have financial intelligence authority, we have committees in parliament.
Yes.
We have security, we have Minister of Finance that approves these financial transactions. And you wait for a whistleblower. And yet we are aspiring to transit into the middle income. You don't just get into the middle income by chance. It's deliberate. And people don't just prosper or come out of poverty by just talking. You must make actions. There must be disciplines that must be protected. There must be individuals that are willing to toll this. There must be people who are in positions, strategic positions, that are concerned about the welfare of Ugandans, the needs in their services, the goals that lead you into the middle income you're talking about. I am talking about middle income because it is the only measure how you can tell that a country is progressing. When its citizens can meet their basic needs,
mm-hmm.
can have at least a section of it is involved in production,
yes.
or a section is it in it is in employment, You cannot have a country that is growing because you have, they are employed by government.
Yeah.
So you must have a fully active and robust private sector. The private sector, for it to grow, you must put in place certain parameters. You understand?
Yes, sir.
You must have incentives. You have to have programs put in place. The president is always telling, how do we grow if we have expensive money on the market? How do you grow if you have expensive electricity? Because you are involving yourself in production. So the bills, the calls, the bills, the facilitators, it's themselves must be in a position to let you save some money.
Okay.
Last night, and this is where I have problems, URA had started very well. So last night I was somewhere and then I saw a group of some people meeting with some officials from URA and they are negotiating.
Negotiating what?
They are negotiating how to cut the bill, I don't know how they call it in their own terms, but their total tax, what URA owes one, and they are negotiating how to
find
to kulegeza, So you have people in offices pursuing their own interests. You understand?
Yes, sir.
So if you have such a community and you are about very few of you saying this is wrong, then you become the wrong person.
So this is the issue you have with parliament?
That is the issue in parliament. Now, let me tell you. Rubaga division spends about 11 billion.
For what?
11 billion.
For what?
Per financial year.
Okay.
Hmm?
Yes.
That is the money allocated for Rubaga division.
Yes.
The budget of the deputy speaker in parliament is 13 billion.
Mm-hmm.
The budget of the speaker is equivalent, actually.
That's also per quarter?
No, per financial year.
Per financial year, yes.
Yeah. The budget of the speaker is equivalent to the budget of the district.
Wow.
Okay, let's not talk about budgets. The spending.
Let's go to the expenditure now.
The expenditure of the speaker, according to what is in social media and which is verified, because the spokesperson of the parliament has come to justify the spending. And some MPs have come to justify the same, saying the speaker always contributes to your fundraisings. Where do you think she gets the money from? Likening it to that of the president.
Wow.
So if you have a budget of the speaker, which is equivalent, when Right Honorable the late, maybe his so rest internal peace, Jacob Oulanyah was speaker the short time, the budget of the speaker then was 1.5 billion.
1.5.
And the deputy speaker was around 800 million. So they revised it. They reviewed it to about 2 billion for the speaker and 1.5 for the deputy speaker. When the Right Honorable, maybe this is my last time to say the Right Honorable, Anita Among came, the budget overshot.
It shoot up?
Shoot up.
Is there anything different what they are doing now that the past speakers never used to do? Because now that the budget is shooting. Are there things that are coming, new things here?
I think they are being too entitled. Some of these things, the other speakers might have been doing them, but they never ever came to the public to see how extravagant they are, to show how they don't care, to show even have no control over what is taking place. You cannot have a parliament that approves a budget that is classified.
Mm.
What is it that is classified in parliament? Ask the legal committee if they have ever seen the budget of parliament. They just see the activity plan. Mm. And you said this is not orchestrated. And you said this is not planned. It is not known. You have a parliament where no one, no member of parliament. Now, you know, in the past, anything would happen and people rush to collect signatures to impeach or to censure anyone in parliament.
But today is something different.
Today it is something different.
So who do you blame for this?
No, I think the leadership of parliament, and I don't want to exonerate the speaker. I think she's being inconsiderate. She's being, the last time I said we have the spirit of Maria Antoinette is reincarnating amongst one of us. And people thought maybe I was being personal.
Yeah, exactly.
Some yeah, of us and I don't think I am being personal.
Where did you get this from? Where did it derive from?
Well, we have a lot of experiences showing up. We have a lot of examples to show. The other time, KCCA doesn't have money to pay sweepers.
Mm.
Can you imagine?
To pay sweepers. Yet there is a lot of money spent.
KCCA, the development budget per quarter of KCCA to do roads in Kampala is about 4 billion. 4 billion
per quarter.
Wow. Now, the speaker spends about 3 billion. Now that is the known structure.
Without knowing somewhere where this
we don't know where these other withdrawals are going. We don't know where Obore is taking money. We don't know where Adiro is taking money. We don't know where Okwi is taking money, but they are taking money in the name of the speaker. We don't know what the speaker is doing in the name of corporate social responsibility. Because as a government, you are supposed to offer services.
That's right.
You don't do corporate social responsibility.
Mm.
And you don't even spend outside the budget. We have a line of service delivered. Why don't you put this money in local government? And in any way, why is the speaker donating all over the country? To me, that is where my interest is. Why would the speaker be donating all over the country? You are donating.
Is there a problem with the speaker donating?
No. You donate with interest.
Oh.
And you donate with what you have.
Maybe this is part of their responsibilities.
Yes. I don't want to assume that now we should all say if we have an opportunity, let's pull money out of service delivery and let's invest in now in promoting our own interest and image.
Oh, this is not done at a level of we are doing this for the country.
No.
It's the personal level.
It is because we have structures. This government decentralized the different channels of service delivery at all levels.
True.
You have a ministry, you have a district, you have a sub-county, you have a municipality, you have a division. You have, now we have cities. All levels, if I want to donate to a district health center, because these health centers are for general services. Mm. So general services are supposed to be offered by government. And this is a quarrel actually that I have been having. You cannot have MPs competing with LC5 and LC3 chairpersons in their districts to offer services. A district has a school, has a hospital, has a road, but doesn't have a budget. Then you hear MPs that they got a bigoma.
to do this
from the Ministry of Works. The Ministry of Works
yes
gives them a bigoma, but it's a constituency.
Bwebatuuka mu constituency ne babyowuninga.
Now, local government is stuck. At the end of the day, abantu tebabanja ono, babanja local government. So local government tesobola kufunctioning. And at the end of the day, local government weta functioning, government teina support.
Okay, katumulu katano gana fe acha tunyonyola ensonga zino kat just a little bit katukupika a little bit just katumulu katano dala tugenda kwa tukoma oni mugana fe ate tuongeleza wenyewe chati fe na kuabana bodogao.
Rush Talk is brought to you
Metropolitan by International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro and Barara. Contact or WhatsApp us on 0772-561-957. Email us at metropolitaniu@gmail.com. Empowerment through knowledge creation.
Ebusega. Tebayina gundi chairman taliwo.
Is brought to you.
Chakati cha tugendo kola.
Rush Talk is brought to you
Metropolitan
by
International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro, and Barara. Contact or WhatsApp us on 0772-561-957. Email us at metropolitaniu@gmail.com. Empowerment through knowledge creation.
Well, thanks so much. Empowerment through creation. That is, of course, our friends there from Kampala Metropolitan International University, who are partners here every day between this time 9 and 10. I'm here with the RSS Rubaga division, Mr. Brora Anderson, looking at how, of course, this whole corruption, fight against corruption with the parliament. He's the man who really speaks his mind, and of course, what's going on? Why don't we go about what you're going to break? How about what was this? I've been to be a ministry and they claim by the never lobbying and because they went. Maybe also, Mr. Brora, by the way, name ministries in over cities, if I could have gone to fetu cosechino. Is it about time? Nabuga Gambuke, to have done this ABCD because baba sirika banonga baje kutwala credit.
Well, ministry nazo zibera zegula. Ministry zegula kubanga bayino chima sente mu parliament. They have to defend their budgets. So they are kinda intimidated. If you don't do this, nafe tukulinze. And every time you see a minister or a PS being bullied in the parliament, just to know. Waliwo kyeyabamye, waliwo ekikyaganya okutuka. Kakati ino soko chukutula ulioko okomewo wano. You watch. Every time you see a PS, it is not that bamu pininga because bafayo nyonyonyonyo. Bamu pininga kubanga aina byatakola ki. So buli MP aina akakiiko kagwako. Oba wa water oja kusanga nga abali ku environment and what nga bagreeding aba water. Because there is no budget that goes to districts for water and sanitation apart from donations and grants. It is the ministry to decide where to put a borehole, where to dig a dam, where to do what. Money, there are very few districts apart from maybe some municipalities and the cities. There is no budget for road construction. Roads are national, UNRA.
Exactly.
Hey, UNRA. But you see, UNRA is constructing roads that are going through districts. Yes, they are national roads. But initially, and I think, but UNRA now, what I'm going to imagine, these are things you could coordinate within districts, and that would reduce on the corruption. Because you find a road that is the same road, Gabobo ina bida. Akankwe chokula bidako.
Yes,
mzee ibagena nebamuwa quotation yo kuziba ebinya mu Kampala KCC. Nebamuwa 11 billions. Ujikile wali exhibition ya potholes. Nebakati nebamuteka ku kisenge like more of a blackmail. But na holding. Na sindika SFC nekola investigations. Nebagamba abina ebinya tusobola obiziba ku 2.7 billion.
Backquoting a year. SFC nega 2.7.
Ni waba olu talo lwa amanyi. Who quarreled Lukwago? Who quarreled some councillors? Now, kakati SFC, but issue is not SFC. Issue is the service. And at what cost are we getting this service? Rwacholo was a volume. We have built capacity to have engineers. Chira Bridge, Chira Gondi, Jinja Bridge was designed by a Ugandan. Most of these roads are designed by Ugandans. Nayolo was a rat, they prefer contractors to be foreign. Why don't you build the capacity to construct your own roads at a cost-effective cost? Nyekati, road districts were road units. Now I am telling you to understand corruption. Districts were road units.
Each district.
Okukora construction. All government needed was buy fuel. We give you money to buy fuel. But you have bought this. Sente zowa contractor. Contractor na ya kola amagoba. Mfuna bulungi. I know ku maintaininga equipment size. I know kusasula abakozi be. I know kugula mafuta, I know kusiga zako. Definitely, the cost is going to be high.
That's right.
Compared to you, when you have your own unit, you have your own staff, you are just buying fuel and maintenance. You are not making profits.
Okay.
You get the difference. So, in 1 year, all the road units were down. Instead of passing money to maintain these units, units are down. We have spent money on these units. A lot of money. Never zit. Never dayo ku procurement. So now they have to procure a contractor. Kukatare kebusega na ringamba na ye. tukola parking nga tukola parking ya katali ne parking iliya rekesi si oyina kufuna contractor zetu sobola kuzimba parking ya katali tuina kufuna contractor
wetaka kufuna professional.
No, 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 you see, Kate, that is where we abuse ourselves now. That to date, we have not built capacity to have professionalism. To have no kuzibebinya, you have to procure. Would that to approach what in the studying, Kati again, or kuzibebinya, to approach what in the gundi again, or kuzibebinya? It does not make sense. Because here, we are struggling to do what? To create an infrastructure that enables the economy.
Yes.
To create an infrastructure that can support and boost the economy. Transport, abatambuza byamaguzi, abatambuza public transport, abavuga to enable movements and what. But we have spent more money in making others rich while depriving the country of the progress. And to me, that is problematic. And I think, katinzi manjibwa, katinzi joku TV, Romeo zintandiko kugamba, kakati olaba, speaker tumunene mugwanga, kakati newaba asasanya, ngeri waliwo ayagala agamba nti ekubo lya feri neno lino twetaaga milioni nga lunana.
Mulimu gwa government.
Mulimu gwa government.
Sikwa
kakati nze nkola mu government.
True.
Kakati sisobola ku compromising ku standards government ze ino okubaako. Atenzi limu kugamba nti kakati to supporting abantu abakole ebyabwe. So I have issues, but also the tukoza amateeka. Tutadeo facilities hizo na zenebolinga okutransforminga. Yete tuinza kumanga vya tuogeda, sivya tukola.
It's true.
Under what circumstances should government money go to individual account? You can't have staff of parliament, staff not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six. Receiving huge sums of money, who are not suppliers of government, who are not offering a service. In any case, even if you are making a donation, that donation, you have to have a request of that donation. You must have a resolution approving that statement, that donation. But also lastly, that money goes directly to the beneficiary.
Mr. Anderson.
Mfuna bulunji.
Mfuna bulunji.
Leka akati wano tugezeru amiti. Vision Group. Limu kukola tugeze corporate social responsibility.
Yes, yes.
Mbu, ramiti yari receiving a cent. Is that corporate social responsibility? Okay, to what? To what is corporate social responsibility? It's an activity. You must explain the activity. You must give the rationale. You must give us reasons why we are paying 300 millions. What are the returns? All of those things must be approved. Whether you request the money or not, whether it is within your docket or not, you must audit, you must account. I hope you understand.
I hear you. Which is why I'm asking, who will check Parliament now? Because it seems the law gives the Parliament too much power.
I don't think now Parliament can check itself. To be honest, I don't think government can audit Parliament. Because initially I told you can't be doing these things. 2022, you do them. 2023, yeah. You do them. 2024, you are doing them. You have IGG. You have Auditor General. And now if you look at the Auditor General's reports, it's also alarming. It's no longer a report. It's an alarm. It's an alarm. Because you look for facts, you look for figures, you look for... When we went to this, we found this, but you don't mention exactly what...
The findings, what exactly is involved?
We advised them.
That's the report.
That is the report. I read the entire document, looking for something incriminating, and everything is surface.
Maybe they did better.
No, they were doing better before than now.
Now, it seems the public is confidence in MPs and parliament is reducing. What happens now?
Now, to me, I don't think we should be doing parliament's work of doing accountability. The best way to do it, and this is what we are coming up to now, the best way to do it now is to forcefully make parliament and MPs understand that it is their job. Before we come to do the demonstration, before we come to do the shouting, let's put account the parliament to account. If the speaker has flouted ABC, what are the grounds, you know, of removing a speaker, that ABCD? Uh-huh. Are they there?
Okay, assuming they're there.
If they are there, do it. MPs are not going to have Easter with us in their constituencies if they don't take action. We are going to chase MPs out of these communities.
Is that possible?
Yes. It is possible. MPs, this Easter, we are going to chase them in churches, in public meetings, in mosques, everywhere they go.
It might be a good idea, but do you think our people can buy this?
I think people are tired. I think people are tired. Yeah. People are tired. People are bitter. People are bitter. Kugambi kakati gwe ramiti rakuba gokola ku TV. Bova wano pozi no genda ku lunch. Totubera nnyo mu bantu bali abali abaine ebyeta.
Abalonzi.
Kati tubera mu community meetings. Tubera mu community, tubera mu bantu. Omuntu nasituka nakubuuza, naye ddala ddala sisi. Ffe nga tuyita mu bino. Edduuka lyange baaligaddirwa license. Ebintu byange baabitottembu kino. Nze bangobye ku kkubo nga ssente ze mutujjako muzisaasaanya bwe mutyo. Ffe mulowooza, tetutegeera. Nfuna bulungi. Olwaleero bwe tuba tugenda okwogerera ku president ne government, abantu bakubuuza tubeebaza ki? Tubawa akalulu lwaki? Kukola bino. Bino bya speaker bisuula government. Tutandika twekalakaasa lwa speaker ne government nekola ki? Kati gavumenti erina okuvaayo ebakuba amasasi, ebakuba tear gas, ebasibe, n'ebikalakaasa ku bibakwatako. Kati nga tetunaba bali tebannaba kusibwa, tebannaba kuba tear gas, tebannaba kujja basirikale mu barracks. Why don't we stop it and do what is right? Lwaki tuteeka ekifaananyi ky'abasirikale mu mbeera gye kitasaana? You see, this is what calls for abuse of human rights. That is why security is put on the spot. That in the process of executing, sanitizing, or maybe protecting someone who is in wrong, now the image goes to them. Ono bamukutte bubi, ono bamusambye bubi, ono bamusindise bubi, ono bamusibye. Kakati, ekifaananyi ne kiva ku oli, ne kidda now ku broader government. So why don't we stop this? An individual, one or two or three. Even audit, check parliament. Kilaka achakola chimu parliament.
I want you to rate the performance of our opposition this time. They have also been accused of taking part into this corruption. We overrating, do we actually have
them? We don't have opposition.
Tuna principle. Omulabo of Rwanda human rights. Yagambye era agoba n'enguzi. Ky'ova olaba abakutte ssente yagambye abagobi.
Account zenguze zimuli ko zimani.
Aha, si zimani mko wa.
To zimani.
Zimbuli liko zimu. Na atuwa bulu.
To mani iti buli mwezi. Buli mwezi. Asolo za babaka.
Iba nguze wa.
To chimani iti buli mubake ya funa cent. Ya mojake milioni kumi.
Buli ya funa kasenta ya mojamu bukade kumi.
Ya mojako bukade kumi. Eze motoka. Wait, sagara being gidam. Eyo debate jiwe mu mwezi. Eya accountability mwene yupi. Jiwe mu mwezi. Always than always. The accountability in yoni yupi. You will be shocked. Bobby Wine aja kuduka mugwanga.
Ile kanawe.
Bobby Wine aja kuduka mugwanga.
Avudeo na akulaga, tuluwa nisenguzi.
Give it time, no.
Na mwana na akulaga, nti kakati nzenenge ntepe, waliwe chali wange, kakwatemu.
Omanyi, nadine wazo kuogera kudebate. But logically,
yes,
tuinache tuita institutional politics. To me, chagula nichi yali asingo kola. Itandi muwade credit. Given what is taking place in parliament, he would withdraw his MPs. Withdraw them. Said we cannot take part as a national unity platform. We cannot take part in such illegalities. We are withdrawing from parliament. All our MPs, we are recalling them. Asigala ya asigala yokululwe. Nukula crusade. That is one. Two. Nogamba nange monsonyiwe. Na ingize motoka. Mubulimba. Nibanguamu. Na ino kusasulu umusolo. Obaba angungere kamubuchamu wa mubutufu. Na ina ino kusasulu umusolo. Sagu sasula. Nange nkozechi. Sente zizi na nzikozechi. Nzidesi. Mwati nyingira munda. Yes, no debate eja. Eja kuja mubudu wayo.
Ulinga kama eringa script kwetambuli ila antikati chino chige enda chino chichida.
No, because when you gamba anti, this is the corrupt.
And we are wiping out. We are corruption into
jijia. Now it is
the
onus. Is on you to be clean.
I'm already clean by removing this
Kakati, mukulwana enguzi kuno. Tetugamba nti gundi ye mutufu, gundi ye muchamu.
Kitufu.
Because if enatu yine bizibu, including me.
Kitufu.
Nene bizibu.
Kitufu.
Mfuna bulungi. Kakati, bwenafe enatu yine bizibu. Kuno kubanga kulokoka. It's like getting saved. All of us as a country must get saved. The point we are at, everyone is a beneficiary. For your information. Wali wa kubasente, nga inechi zimbe cha zimba. Katiba mubanja. Wakozi wa mubanja, hadiwe ye mubanja, gundi ye mubanja. Uluwale no blocking a tap season na. Uinzo labi ebizimbe bitaddamu kusituka.
Zino nda sendeza mwe omusobe bizimbe tulaba. Mulu zitambule ino, simanya bano bakoze bati zonna sendeza mwe omusolo.
They don't know blocking. All taps. You will be shocked.
Naye wana mukulala disi otugambira. Nti bolaba side eno iyo ya NRM. Abantu bangi bazze babera mu skando. Sente bazikutte amabati twagalaba. Twali kibakoleddwako. Kati atono na avayo na agamba watuwali ibita anubino. Kati guriza ininga.
Kakati.
Ani haba hako zao?
Kakati. Ibita anu. It is as a. It is by. Te yatuwala vituwala inti ya visika manju. Chachivicha na vada government wali uo. Institutional politics. Botuka mu institution yonna. muri mu politics wam nafe mu institution yafe ya baradis tuina politics wafe namu wano kati nze nenzi ja wano nga nzi jo kola kinzo okuntwalira emyezi nga mukaga tukopa
kitufu
kuba simanya ni wa kulinya ko simanyi gwe nina
bwe
simanyi gwe mbuza ne gwe sibuza simanyi kugamba byo nokola ki you should put into account that now this one has an argument. All others have emoluments. You get it? They have packages given to them when they are leaving. Those packages in public service, they are acceptable. Nchuribu wabama zemiri munga nyuka, bamu wachino na chino na akolachi, na agenda na
chuku.
Walabie no mula mzifoma principal judge na mula vie kumu mauliri. Mbu gundi zize bamu wantono ayagala kwenkanya ne chief justice ne deputy chief justice gundi yaliko wa NSSF at some point ya gambo ba obukadde bwe mumpo bana mu bumeko bana mu butano ba atano zimupa antono okusinzira mu region nze nswala Wengenda ni mubanange mu mawanga
kuswala.
ya swala bamu wa milioni ana mutano
ntono
kakati ta...
Oh my God,
mfuna bulungi.
Yes,
so now the legislation we are looking at, we are focusing on strengthening positions of people and look at the spending. How much money are we spending in pensions? How much money are we spending in indoor activities? We have activity A, kuserena, activity B, kusheraton, activity C. But what value do they add? Buri budget kati jolaba, tugenda kusomesa abantu. Tugenda kusomesa abantu ukunywa coffee. We must beat the bureaucracy that is in the civil servants. Now, are they funds a budget? The development budget, we have a consuming now government. Since when did the government start consuming? You cannot have a consumptive government. No. No. So kati bulola ba ministry yonna olaba tugenda kola otugenda genda mu kigezi okusomesa padiem allowances. Now the money in allowances in all MDAs zizimba olugudo lwa kilomita nga 10.
For real?
Yeah, the money is in allowances. No, during COVID. These are evidence. The evidence is there. During COVID, by revising a budget year 2020-2021, jukira COVID yaja tulimo quote December, March, around there. They were revising a budget year 2020-2021. Do you know how much was realized?
No.
5 trillion. 5 trillion. That we are going in travels, conferences, per diems, what all of that wasteful expense. 5 trillions. Genosade ya yita budget ni vajidamu. Vajirivaizinga buto. They realized 5 trillions that was going to be wasted. Now, you have 50 to now budget. By then I think it was 49. 49 again, 48, 49 budget, trillions. You have 5 trillions that was realized. Kakati 5 trillions, kati ye budget, chenkana ye budget ya wax.
Financial year.
Financial year. Over energy. A single education, because education is about 2.2, 2.4.
And yet, and
the single year heresy. That is money that was going to a waste. So if I tell you that we need to fight the bureaucracy of civil servants, the greed, the graft now that civil servants have surrounded on the budget. The budget is captured. The budget is captured. I am telling you. They supposed to implement a budget.
Yes.
Because my line of duty allows me to go everywhere, to look into everything that government does without restrictions, for your information, without restriction.
Both government,
yeah?
Do you access the information?
I have. This information is classified. Kugambia budget ya parliament is classified.
Do you have any problem with the speaker?
As an individual?
Yes.
No.
Is she your friend?
I don't think we are friends.
Do you talk to her? RCC Anderson Burora, our good friend here, trying to see, you know, issues here and there. At Nyumia Mombos, the interview movie number, and any time he could take Uganda. But in Saba, we just one, we'll see you later. I'm going to go to the other one. I'm going to go to the other one. I'm going to go
to the other one. But in Jagalanzo, Kusaba, whether or manyo, but or many, the Chintuchino, she slow winger in Kula Kuranaya. Tusasula amabanja trillions nga kumi na munana. Kumi around there, kumi the financial year debts. And I've told you that we have about 5 trillion. Zigena mubintevitators. We need to revise this capture on the budget. Wakuba tuchiwaiden nzene tuchijia kone ku parliament. This capture of the budget needs to be reviewed. And it is okay. Our call now to explain to our leaders, including me, that at this point we need to rethink. We need to look into ourselves and look at the demands of the public, of the communities we stay in. It does not make sense into good one meeting a community yo. Go weka in any number yet but
abalanga bali
chikufura vulnerable chikufura wakabi obera vulnerable.
Thank you very much. Of course, kwa tuwa demu kana fetunyumia mtu jia muzi ya wabai na mkubude atunyumia atuberinga atungiru tusomesa kwa chikuru ukuwanga tumanyi mgena masu mwati msiri kwa na mtu atuwele kuzada. Thank you so much for some friends, family mwena bagama chukete na fecha kwa chati tuwa nika usawa kumina bideri. Thanks so much Andrew and of course the team here, Hadija and the team for, you know, being part of every day here in the morning. Thank you and have a great day. Bye bye.
Rush Talk is brought to you
Metropolitan
by
International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro, and Barara. Contact or WhatsApp us on 0772-561-957. Email us at metropolitaniu@gmail.com. Empowerment through knowledge creation.
Rush Talk is brought to you
Metropolitan International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala.